The dreaded pillow face. It's turning you off from getting anything put in your face because you think Botox causes it, fillers, remember a lot of different things are fillers, or maybe it's devices, HIFU. Everyone asks about high frequency ultrasound. Can that cause pillow face? What are people referring to? That's when the face just looks round, overfilled, doughy, not shapely, and you want to avoid it. It's easy to avoid. The most difficult type of face to treat is the round face, and I have a whole video on face shapes and how you can determine your face shape. I'll put it in the description below, but the round face shape already starts that way, but it can be avoided even in that most difficult of face shape, so don't worry, but there's five main reasons it happens. Number one, what you will want to avoid, getting too much hyaluronic acid filler. A lot of people, as we know, by the age of 40, you lose 15 mLs, even much more in the face, bone, muscle, fat pads, under eye. So to replace 15 mLs or one tablespoon would be 15 syringes. It's not out of the question, but if you only use hyaluronic acid filler to do it, that draws water in, it creates a puffy look, and it lasts a long time in the body. A lot of people believe when something's 1 year FDA approved, at 1 year it magically is all gone. But that has nothing to do with it. The approval trials are for how long they can get a result, and it behooves a company to get it approved quicker, so it goes to market, than to see what it does at many years out. So understand HA fillers, hyaluronic acid fillers, the most commonly used. They can be dissolved, but you shouldn't use too many of them. And over time, they do build up, so you can fall into that trap. Number two, people, especially in North America, do not embrace devices. So you should embrace devices, high frequency ultrasound, radio frequency, CO2 lasers. They're not going to volumize the face, but depending on the one, they're going to build collagen. They're going to keep you. So you don't have pillow face or same face syndrome where everyone looks the same. They are going to help build collagen. They're going to give you more glow. They're not going to change the angles, the folds, or who you are, but they will build collagen, tighten the skin, increase glow, decrease brown spots, all the great things. And I did a video on Viora's VFR, fractionated RF. I do many on RF microneedling. Those are great choices so that you don't get pillow face. Number three, embrace PDO threads, collagen-stimulating, biostimulating injections. In that same realm, I'll put, we have PDO threads, they build collagen, they don't add a lot of volume to the face. Biostimulators such as Sculptra, Plasma Sculpt, platelet-rich fibrin, those are all, depending on what level of natural you want, you can use them, PRF being the most natural. It's all you, comes from your own blood products. Those are biostimulators that help build collagen, but they don't have to add the volume and they don't attract water like hyaluronic acid fillers do, and that is a key. I would throw in radius in there too, calcium hydroxyl apatite. The number four thing is paying attention to angles. That's up to you. And you have to find a great injector, a great aesthetic provider. If you don't study and know the angles, they should, preferably both of you, negotiate. And in my consult, I say the Rajani consult, number one, R, requesting information, A, assessing. So you're assessing the person and their angle. So there's a whole video I have on the consult, but it's number two, in the consult listing so that you talk about angles, proportions, what people want to look like so they're not overdone or underdone for the look they're going to, but angles have to be taken into consideration to the patient's desire and should not be just filling the face. That gets me to my problem number five. When you just fill the face, why? People think it lifts. So by volumizing it, the more filler we add, the more lift you get. While that can be true if you're creating angles at the same time. When people are trying to lift a jowl, they might do their cheek filler, they want more lift, why not add it in here? And you cannot blunt the zygomatic angle or the cheekbone because the cheek is beauty, it's youth, it's fertility. And if you blunt that angle, you lose all of that and you create the pillow face, the dreaded puffy face. Those are five things you should watch for. I put a complete playlist right up here on beauty angles, and I put one down here on treatments you can do at home to help maintain the angles you already have, decrease the need to go and get aesthetic services done, and keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.